So now, third chapter of our syllabus, that is audio system. As far as the audio system goes on, we should know what are the different types of amplifiers. We should know the amplification is there, and then you should know the equalization of that signal. Then we should know what are the different recording techniques for it. And after learning all these things, we should know what is an application, that is a public address system. So we should know this amplifiers like mono and stereo amplifier, first point. Second point is block diagram of amplifier. Third one is graphic equalizer. We should know circuit diagram and its operation. Fourth point is Dolby NR recording system. In that we have to study the graph presentation, waveform presentation, right? And last one is the application of this audio system is the PA system, that is public address system. In that we should know the need, the use, block diagram and requirements of it. Our Dhut sir has also prepared the PPT of it. We have to refer that PPT also with respect to our notes also. Thank you. So the next now is a difference between the monophonic amplifier and the stereophonic amplifier. So the first point is referring to our notes also and this particular slide also. The mono means what actually? It is one. Fine, one. And what is phonic means what? It's a sound. So in mono means one and phone means what? Nothing but a sound. And so amplifier using is having only one sound. Stereo means what? Stall it, and phone means sound. So that is what it's a stereophonic. These are the meaning of the two words. So what it says in next point is that monophonic sound is supposed to be from a single channel, okay, and it will be like coming from only one position. But in case of stereo, we will realize or we will have the illusion that the sound is coming from the two direction. Means so in terms of principle of operation, we can say sound appears to be come from one source or in one direction. But in stereophony, sound appears to be coming from the surrounded directions. Now, third is a cost. What is the cost of monophonic is that it is a less expensive for the recording as well as the reproduction. Means in comparison with the stereophony. So, and the cost of stereophony is what? It's a more expensive than the monophony in terms of recording as well as the reproduction also. Then we should know that what is its description as a monophonic amplifier. In monophonic, it has got only one sound source, one amplifier, one direction and one loudspeakers. In stereophonic, we have naturally we have got two ears, then two amplifiers and two loudspeakers. So in that case, then what we see is that the recording is easy to record, and in case of the monophonic or stereo system, in the monophonic recording system, therefore in this one stereophonic case is that it requires a technical knowledge and a skill to record apart from the equipment. Means it has got a certain skills to record the through that equipments in case of stereophony as compared to the monophonic. Means it is important to know how the relative position of the objects and events. Means if the sound is coming from the different direction, the location of the microphone, location of the particular loudspeakers and audience matters the most. Then audio signals are routed through a single channel. As we all know that in monophonic system, audio signals are routed through single channel. And in stereophonic, audio signals are routed through two or more channels in order to what? Stimulate the depth, direction, perception like a real world. So as in stereophonic, it's nice that we are having two or more channel and we get it's a simulation is there of a particular depth direction like we are in the real world. So that is a benefit of the what we can say with respect to what stereophonic system. Then as far as the application goes on, public address system, radio talk shows, hearing aid like telephone and mobile communication, and some AM radio station. Naturally, it all goes with a monophonic system actually, right? Means whenever we require a monophonic amplifiers or monophonic system, we straightway public address system, radio talk shows, hearing, telephony, and some AM radio station comes. So when we think of stereophonic, naturally we will require a big application such as movies, television, music players, FM radio systems and all that. In case of monophonic channels is only one, and in stereophonic it is two. Equalizers are not used in monophonic, and equalizers are used in the stereophonic, right? A nonlinear distortion is there in the monophonic. In stereophonic, nonlinear distortion is there, but not more than the input and output. And the last one is our main signal to noise ratio. It less signal to noise ratio is there, and in signal to noise ratio is better than 50 dB in case of a stereophonic amplifier system. So this is with respect to what difference between the monophonic and stereophonic system. In the diagram also we have to write, we can draw as such that a microphone we will show first, then preamplifier, then tone and volume control, then power amplifier and the loudspeakers, and you repeat in stereophonic by drawing two, one for the left channel and another for the right channel. Same will be repeated for the both the channels, right? Thank you for this mono and stereo amplifier system. Now we will move for the hi-fi systems, that is high fidelity system. Fine. So the first thing we should know that what is the meaning of the word fidelity. The word fidelity means here it's a hi-fi, word fidelity means over here faithfulness. Means the fidelity, the meaning of the fidelity is a faithfulness. So hi-fi audio system means what? A faithful reproduction of the sound. So the faithful reproduction is a technical meaning of what means what happens in a hi-fi is that the reproduction should be faithful. So there are certain characteristics of ideal hi-fi amplifier system. Before going into the characteristic of our hi-fi amplifier system, let us ponder on the characteristic of an ideal hi-fi system. So in that signal to noise ratio, it should be infinity. All noise must be totally eliminated. It's an ideal case, so we can consider signal to noise ratio is equal to infinite. Then frequency response. How should be the frequency response? It should be flat over our entire audio frequency range. Our frequency audio range is what? Around 16 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Means we can hear this is a total audio frequency, and in that particular spectrum of audio, we should get a flat frequency response over the entire coverage of audio. Then non-linear distortion should be zero. Then system should have a dynamic range. Means the system should have a dynamic range from 0 to 130 dB. Then last one is system should be capable of giving the sense of direction to the listener. Means this will help the listener to identify the relative position of a different sound sources in the original program. For example, the sensing of a direction, for example, if the orchestra is going on, and we should know that from which direction which particular sound is coming, and when the program is run, we should really sense the direction. So that is with respect to the ideal characteristics of the hi-fi system. Fine. And then what is requirement of a hi-fi system? So what is the requirement? Signal to noise ratio should be greater than 50 dB straightway, flat frequency response in the range of 14 hertz to 15 kilohertz, non-linear distortion should be less than 1%, dynamic range should be 20 dB to 100 dB, if not at least 80 dB, and stereophonic reproduction should be there to give the sense of direction. So what we have seen is that the meaning of the hi-fi system, what are the ideal characteristics of the hi-fi system, what are its requirement, and then now we will switch to the diagram. So in the diagram we can see the hi-fi amplifier system that at the input side We are giving the input with respect to the tape playback, with respect to the disc playback, and other with respect to the microphone. So whatever the input which is going to come out, it is operated on a two independent channel, as we can see. One is the left channel and another one is the right channel. So here it is like that, the high fidelity sound can be reproduced from a single recorded which is signal which is recorded on the tape or taken from the live recording, or it can be taken from the different microphones, right? So then the selected signal from source is then applied to what? A separate channel. So as I said, whatever the signals which we are taking as an input, that will be applied to the separate channel, which is the left channel as well as the right channel. Then what it passes through actually is the chain of preamplifiers, equalizer, then matching circuit, and all precaution, and we should take all precaution to keep the noise content as low as possible to get the frequency response at a flat range, right? And it should be around, and we should get a flat frequency response from 40 hertz to 15 kilohertz. Then at the last, we should know what are the different system it consists of. One is the first one is low noise amplifier, equalizer, properly designed amplifier with a flat frequency response. It should have low distortion, matching circuit is given, right? And the last one is a balancing circuit for the making the characteristics of both the channel balanced. So this is what with respect to what we should realize the particular diagram of a hi-fi system. Then as far as the characteristics go on, particular characteristics of the hi-fi amplifier. The first one is signal to noise ratio, it should be better than 50 dB. Then frequency response should be within the flat limit of plus or minus 1 dB. Non-linear distortion should not be more than 1%. The system should possess a high dynamic range of at least 8 dB. And the stereophonic effect sound should be produced. And the last one is the features of it, what the functions particularly of this particular hi-fi system is. What are the different functions? One is a balance control, master gain control, blank control, quasi control switch, bass and treble control, and loudness control. So we should know what actually this is, the one of the two or three things are always asked in the exam. Thank you. Now let us go for the graphic equalizer. So what is this graphic equalizer is actually? So the graphic equalizer tells us that, you know, it's a one type of a tone control circuit. Why we are calling a tone control circuit? Because what is the tone? We say now to the people what tone he is having or she is having, there should be a tone control as such. So means what? We are increasing the volume or decreasing the volume. This is a roughly what we can say. But graphic equalizer, we have to understand it in a different way. So what is in a graphic equalizer is that, as we all know, we are having the audio spectrum. Audio spectrum means what? Right from some 16 hertz to the 20 kilohertz. So this is our audio spectrum, right? So this audio spectrum is divided into bands, narrow bands, I can say. Fine. So this audio spectrum is divided into several narrow bands. Then each band has a separate slider. I repeat, each band has got a separate slider. As we have seen in the old equalizers, we are having a sliders. With the help of that sliders, we can boost or we can cut the signals, right? So we can bass and boost, as well as the we have to cut. So the boost or cut phenomena is there with the help of the slider. We want to boost the sound, we make the slider upside, and we when we want to go down or we do not want to listen, we keep the slider downside. So this band is from plus 15 dB to minus 15 dB. So we can boost the signals to plus 15, or we can cut the signals towards the minus 15 dB as shown in the figure, right? So this is one thing. In a nutshell, I can tell you we are dividing the audio spectrum into different band. Each band is having a different slider. With the help of the slider, we can boost or we can cut. Limit is up to plus 15 dB or minus 15 dB. Fine. Then next, the center frequency of each band, as we see in the diagram, there's a center frequency of one or two waves, and there in mid portion is called as the octave, or we can call it as a three octave interval. Then the frequency response of the curves for the different band with the center frequency at one octave is interval. So as we can see from the diagram, the frequency response curves we can see for the different types of bands, and the center frequencies are at the one octave, as we can see. So now let us see the definition of a graphic equalizer, what it is actually. So we know it is possible for us to increase or boost and decrease or to cut the magnitude of what frequency components in each band. Means we can boost or we can boost or we can cut, right? We can increase or decrease what the magnitude of the frequency in each band independently with the help of our slider, as I mentioned before. With the help of the slider, we can change the magnitude of a frequency, and this process is known as a equalization, and the circuit which performs this equalization is known as a graphics equalizer. Fine. So what is the need then? So what it says, as a graphic equalizer can boost or cut a bunch of frequencies as per the user's choice to enhance the overall experience of listening the music. So I can tell you, if you remember anything from the movies that is shown in different types, you know, that singer is singing the song inside actually, and from the opposite side, the opposite of the singing room, when a big equalizer is there, and that person, director or a music director, is just controlling the knobs as it is increasing and decreasing certain amount of frequency with that particular band and with that particular range with the help of the slider. This is observed in very much of movies in which the recording studio is shown. So this is what a graphic equalizer is, right? So in the diagram also we have seen that we see that frequency range is from minus 20 dB to plus 20 dB, fine. From the zero it is shown, then from 0 to 20 dB, actually it goes up only up to 15 dB, as we can see from that particular graph. Plus 15 and minus 15, plus 15 and minus 15 is not shown, but minus 20 and plus 20 is shown, right? So boosting is up to 15k and cutting is up to minus 15k, right? Now the diagram which is shown in the last is the simplified circuit diagram of the graphic equalizer. As we can see the transistors, then of it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, right? They are the filters, and considering with that filters, we are having a respective slider controls, right? Means frequencies applied to the filter section, and from the filter section, sliders are operated, and then it is given to the output, fine. So let us see what it is now from the block diagram. So what does block diagram tells us? That input signal is sent to the bank of filters, as we have seen, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, right? Then each filter passes the portion of what signal present in the frequency range. Whatever the frequency is allocated to that filters in that frequency, is that particular frequency signal is passed, right? Then section A, B, C, D, E, F, G, these are filters whose amplitude is adjusted by using the sliders, or we can say by the slide controls, to boost the frequency or to cut the frequency passed by that filters. Means we are having a sliders just to boost or cut, right? Or we can say it by sliders are operated for increasing and decreasing the signals. So normally what we say, all equalizer bands are kept at zero, fine, and in the middle actually. Then the speaker output come out without any gain or any kind of effects, just then by changing the slider position, and depending on the listener's choice, we can increase the frequency of a particular band. So the mid range is normally around what 1400 hertz to 1.6 sorry, 400 hertz to 16 kilohertz, right? Then the lower side of the bus and the higher side on the right hand side is 16 kilohertz. The equalizer knobs or gain can be adjusted by just by sliders, and the volume is turned to a desirable level once the frequency starts liking by a person. So this is all about what graphic equalizers, right? Thank you. Yes. Now we are giving a thought to noise reduction with a Dolby NR. What is Dolby NR? Dolby NR is a name given to the series of noise reduction system. Means it's a series with the help of which different types of techniques were used, and the techniques were applicable for the reduction of the noise. And it was developed by the Dolby Laboratories. And where it was used in the magnetic tape recording. Fine. So Dolby noise reduction system is a form of what dynamic pre-emphasis is deployed at the time of recording. Fine. And plus a form of dynamic de-emphasis during the playback. So you should understand the recording phenomena as well as the playback phenomena. At the time of this one recording, pre-emphasis takes place, and at the time of playback, what happens? A dynamic de-emphasis takes place, right? And it also is used for improvement of the signal to noise ratio. Fine. So now let us go for this Dolby A, right? Dolby A operates, a system is also called as Dolby A, Dolby B, Dolby C, right? There are many systems as such. So while Dolby A operates across the whole spectrum, means the entire audio spectrum it operates, and the systems specifically emphasize on the audible range, which are and where the background of a hiss sound is there, that is tape hiss sound, right? And which the similar to the white noise actually, right, which is above 1 kilohertz. So that hissing sound is also taken into account, and it is also that is very much similar for to white noise actually, right? Now what is the entire concept is, so what does the Dolby A system is doing is it reduces the noise in a quiet passages of a signal, means in a signal it is reducing the noise, right? Where the noise is more noticeable, means where the noise is noticed at that time, it reduces the noise, and in the frequency range where the human ear is more sensitive. Fine. So whenever we people hear the sound, and where we can notice that particular noise is present in that particular signal, so at that time what happens, the Dolby system tries to reduce the noise. Fine. So referring to the figure, the graphs is given. One is with respect to tape noise at a high frequency, then pre-emphasis during recording, and after de-emphasis, right? So noise reduction Dolby system is that graphs are given with reference to these graphs. Let us discuss some points. So we should know that as far as the graph is concerned, pre-emphasis is given during the recording, is shown in the graph. Then de-emphasis is given on a replay, means playback and recording. So as we all know, pre-emphasis during recording and de-emphasis during the playback. Fine. So then Dolby A system is one of the professionally used for this. So Dolby pre-emphasis does the job of boosting the recording level of a audio signal, means whatever the signals which are recorded, the boosting of the signal takes place at a higher frequency, right? Effectively. Fine. Then the dynamic range of the signal that is quite above the 1 kilohertz, means the signals which are above 1 kilohertz are boosted, right? Then as the tape is recorded, the amplitude of the signal above 1 kilohertz is used to determine, means at the while recording what happens, the amplitude of the signal which is above 1 kilohertz, right, it is used to determine how much pre-emphasis will be applied. A low level signal is boosted by a 10 dB. What it says that when tape is recorded, then the relative amplitude to the signal of 1 kilohertz, we are applying the pre-emphasis, right? And there is a boosting of how much? 10 dB or 20 dB. So 10 dB is in the case of Dolby B system, and 20 dB is in the case of a Dolby C system. So the amplitude of the signal above 1 kHz is used for boosting with respect to 10 dB as well as 20 dB with respect to the system. Fine. Then we can see that as a signal rise is takes place, as the signal is rising in the amplitude, okay, so less and less pre-emphasis is applied. Fine. So as a signal amplitude is rise, so less and less pre-emphasis of process is applied, and no signal modification takes place. So the sound is thus recorded at a higher overall level of on the tape relative to the tape's overall noise level. Means with respect to the noise level, the recording takes place at a very high level, requiring the tape formulation nicely. Then what happens at the playback? Then the opposite process is applied, that opposite of means de-emphasis takes place as opposite of pre-emphasis on based on the relative signal component above 1 kHz, and it operates on the above 1 kHz frequency. Then the portion of the signal decreases in the amplitude. As we see during the de-emphasis, what is happening here, there is a decrease in the amplitude, and the higher frequencies are progressively more sharply attenuated. This is very important. As the signal amplitude decreases, the higher frequencies are progressively attenuated sharply, which also filters out the constant background noise. Means background noise is also filtered over here, and thus it is very easily noticeable. So as far as the graphs are concerned, we can see that pre-emphasis graph, which is in which the constant noise tape and the frequency and the audio frequency, which is without pre-emphasis, then the pre-emphasis takes place at which the amplitude is raised, right, and there is no change in the Dolby frequency. And the last, while the de-emphasis, the amplitude is decreasing, and where the progressively there is attenuation of the higher frequencies. So this is with respect to what? Dolby system. Thank you. The last point in this particular chapter of audio system comes to be the application point. So the application point is public address system. Fine. So what is a definition of a public address system is first. Public address system. So when a large gathering of the people is to be addressed, election rallies has to be addressed, then assembly of the school, you can say. So that type of addressing, right? The sound must be amplified so that the people away from the stage can listen it comfortably. So for example, if the cricket ground matches is there, running commentary is there, then assembly of school, the addressing of any political leader to the mass. So in that particular case, each and every person who is away from that particular stage should listen it very properly. And this system, the system which allows us to do this, is a public address system. Right. So technically, public address system is what? It is nothing but a combination of a set of audio equipment that allows to broadcast over a designated area. Fine, this is the definition of it. So let us go through this particular point of PA system, right? So what it consists of, as far as the conventional block diagram is concerned, we should have the microphones, multiple microphones, right? Then it is given to the mixer. From the mixer, then a voltage amplifier is there. As usual, we have a tone control processing circuits, then driver, lastly the power amplifier and the loudspeaker. So these are the traditional blocks of it. So I repeat, microphone at the input part, given to the mixer for mixing. Amplification is done by initial voltage amplifiers, then processing is done with respect to tone control gain, then it is given to the driver then given to the power amplifier, and lastly to the loudspeaker unit. Fine. So this is the conventional blocks of the PA system, right? So what is in the notes is what is given into the notes actually, so that we will see. Fine. So as we see in the notes, the what are the requirements of the public address system. So what it requirements in the sense, it should fulfill that condition. So it must avoid the acoustic feedback, so whatever the noise which comes, it should not come as a feedback. Then distribute the sound intensity uniformly in every corner that sound should be uniform. Reduce the revibrations, there should not be any revibrations as such. So it must use a proper speaker orientation, that means the direction of the speakers, the orientation of the speakers should be properly made. Select proper microphones and loudspeakers. The choice of the microphone and loudspeakers should be that considering the area, geographical space, the amount of the persons which are going to come. It creates the sense of direction, means sense of the direction should be also be there. Loudspeaker impedance should be matched properly so we can hear it nicely. Then proper grounding should be provided. Use closed ring connection for the loudspeakers, so the ring format is also for the loudspeaker is compulsory. So the application part which goes on, there are number of the applications we can see. There is a passenger amenity for giving the detailed information for the train travels, departures, late running, location of the trains, this all passengers information can be given. Then marshalling yards, right? Then in railway station we can see all this breakdown train emergency equipment, special functions, right? The wherever the felicitation goes on, the official VVIP's addressing is there. So railway workshops. So we can say anywhere in the school, in the colleges, in the public rallies, in the election rallies, in railway station, airports, name any place which where the public gathering is there, that requires a PA system. Fine. So what we know is that as far as the input, we see the diagram, as far as the input goes on, we have taken a very recent diagram for this PA address system, right? So what it says to us, so let us see that diagram. So at the input stage, what we can see, we can go for music, we can go for microphone over there, right? And we can also give the potential free contact from the another tone also. We can also give the input of the EPBX also, right? So at the input stage, we can see the source of the mic, the source of the music, source of any other tone generator. We can also give the EPBX, right? So then there is a mixing is there. Then we have this all amplifiers, as we can see over here. So this driver amplifiers, all drivers amplifiers, we can see here given to the main junction box. Main junction box we can see over here. So as we see the rack 1 and rack 2. In rack 1 we have monitoring unit, priority module, music sources, digital voice recorders, audio dialer, amplifiers and on termination panels. This is rack 1, and rack 2, the list of the amplifiers are there, and after amplification we are giving to the main junction box, and to this we are attaching the different types of speakers. We can see here distribution of the speakers. This is wall mounted type of speakers we can give. We can also give the ceiling ring speakers, we can also give the column speakers and the horn speakers. So we just need to know the how the flow is, and as far as the exam goes on, we should know the definition of it, we should know the conventional blocks of it, we should know the block diagram, we should know the application and working of it. And that is the end of this audio system. Thank you.